Tab management in Google Chrome has received some major updates in recent years, allowing for substantial gains in browsing efficiency. I harness these features to push Chrome to the absolute max, and my productivity has never been higher. But they're easy to overlook, and I don't want you to miss out. So here are five powerful tab management features of Google Chrome. Number one is Tab Groups. Just right-click on an open tab and click Add Tab to New Group. Give the group a name, choose a color if you'd like, and now you can drag and drop additional tabs into the group. They'll receive the same color highlighting that you chose when creating the tab group. With the group created, all tabs within it can be moved together in the tab bar. You can drag it out and into a new window, or drag it into an already open window. By left-clicking on the highlight color, it can be collapsed and expanded, allowing more room for additional tabs and groups. Right-click on the tab group and choose Save to add this entire group to your bookmarks bar as a single button. When clicked, it will take you directly to this group. Beware though, if you close all of the tabs within the group itself will be deleted from the bookmarks bar. Instead, right-click on the group and choose Hide Group. It will close, but the button will remain on the bookmarks bar, and you can click it to open the group right back up. Tab groups are great, but for your most frequently visited sites, it's best to use feature number two, pinned tabs. Right-click on an open tab and choose Pin. The tab will move to the left side of the tab bar and collapse only to show its icon. The tab will remain pinned until you close it or right-click and choose Unpin. Even if you close your browser and then open it back up, the pinned tab will still be there. Unfortunately, adding a pinned tab to a group will unpin it, meaning you can't create tab groups of pinned tabs. Hopefully in a future update. If you're like me, you probably have dozens of tabs open at any given time. That's where feature number three comes in, tab searching. Click on the drop-down arrow to the top right of Chrome to display a list of all of your currently open tabs, even if they're open in multiple windows. From here, you can close out any tabs that you don't need, then search for the tab that you're looking for at the top and click to be brought directly to it. No more getting lost in an endless sea of tabs. If you have so many tabs open that your computer slows down, feature number four will be your salvation, Memory Saver. Access your Chrome settings, click on the Performance section, and then toggle the option to enable Memory Saver. This will offload unused tabs from Chrome's memory, improving its performance. When you access a tab again, it will update and refresh automatically. Feature number five will provide the final boost, Chrome Keyboard Shortcuts. The list can get quite long, so here are the most important ones. Control or Command T to open up a new tab. Control or Command W to close a tab. Control or Command Shift and T to open up the last closed tab. This one's useful when you get trigger happy with Command or Control W. Command or Control plus N will open up a new browser window. Control Tab will move you to the next open tab, and Control Shift Tab will move you back. Control Shift plus Page Up or Page Down will move the current tab to the right or left on both Mac and Windows. I use these shortcuts all day long, especially when opening and closing tabs. For example, doing a quick search is as simple as Control or Command T, enter the search query, and hit Enter. With fast typing, you can get search results in seconds or less. My workflow wouldn't be the same without these shortcuts. If you're not using them, you have a major opportunity to improve efficiency and save time. Utilizing these features should help you move faster in Google Chrome. If you want to move faster with everything that you do on a computer, check out this video right here where I go over 10 common typing mistakes that a lot of people make. If you enjoyed the video that you're watching right now, give it a like, subscribe for more tech efficiency tips. I'm Anton Alexander, and I'll see you in the next one.